Hi everyone, Plastic EP, yes, from Melbourne, Australia. Now you wanted the grip reeds. Everybody's been asking me for the grip reeds all over the world. I've watched every single one of their videos last night. My head's going boom, boom, boom. Grip weeds. There's only one man who can come on and tell us all about the grip weeds. That's the lead singer and drummer of the grip weeds, Mr. Kurt Ryle, who's wild. How you going, man?
Hey, Plastic, what's happening?
What time is it? It's 11:30 in the morning.
Oh, man, it is 9:30 p.m. here.
Doesn't matter. I love your studio. What's big news in the grip world, in grip weed world? What's happening there?
Well, we're making an album because we can't play live, you know? So we're making a record.
That's great. What else do you want?
Yeah, what more can we do?
Nothing. What do we do? You know what you do now? Get your guitar and play a song. Come on, let's have some.
Oh, you want to hear
some
right
grip weed?
Right? Want to hear something right now?
Yeah, right now.
All right. Well, I just happen to have my guitar right here. All right, you want to hear the whole thing?
Yeah, play. It's original. Play whatever you want. Go for it.
All right, this song is called Realities. It's from the album Giants on the Beach. Version.
That's beautiful. Now, are you a big Monkees fan?
Monkees, I love the Monkees. What's not to like?
What song can you play by the Monkees? Come on.
Oh my god. let's see. Let me think of one here. Train left out in the rain, the day after sun came.
train, left out in the rain. The day after Sunday came, you're not the only charity light in the night. Don't give up without a fight. You're not the only cuddly toy, never a joy.
Hey, listen, we're on a roll here, Kurt. What's a Beatles song? Can you do an early Beatles song? Can you do I Saw It Standing There to rock it up? I need a rocker. I'll never dance with another. Ooh. You can rock it up with the best of them.
Wait till you hear me play drums, man.
I know you can. I know you can. I saw your videos. All right. Tell me where they can see you all over the net.
Gripweeds.com, www.gripweeds.com. Or you can check us out on Facebook. What is it? At Gripweeds, I think. And that's GRIPWEEDS. And then Twitter, Reverb Nation. Just type Gripweeds, you'll find us.
And where can they buy your CDs?
Well, you can get them. You know, the best place to get them, actually, Plastic, is right from gripweeds.com is the best place. We have all kinds of stuff there that you can't get anywhere else. There's, we would put out an album, a CD, download, whatever you want, vinyl. And then we make a deluxe version. And the deluxe version is only available on our website. It's a double-length album. By that time, we have all these extras, live stuff, everything you can think of, we throw in.
You got t-shirts too.
We got t-shirts. Yeah, we got hats. And just in time for winter. You guys are in the winter right now, right?
Yeah, we're freezing down here. Freezing.
See? Yeah, it's summer here.
Do you sell beanies? You know, the ones you put on your head?
No, we got the winter hat. The winter hats. No beanies. Well, the spinner.
You guys are like Kiss. You got everything
without the makeup.
Yes. Now you got to tell me the members of your band. Tell me the members of the band. What their names are and what they play.
Well, my first one could be my brother Rick. Rick Ryle.
Is that the lead guitarist?
Yeah, he's a guitar player.
He's wild, man. That guy, when he goes into a lead break, he like takes off.
Yeah, right. But Kristen Pennell Ryle, she's my wife.
Oh, okay, great. You keep it in the family like I do.
Right, but she's a guitarist. She's a lead player. So she's really, she's the one who plays a lot of wild leads all the time. And then she's been in the band for quite some time now. And then there's Dave DeSantis, who's the bassist. He's the bassist with the mostest. He's good.
Isn't it great when you've got nearly all your family? You got your brother and your wife in the band.
Yeah, I think that helps us stay together, actually. Because
yeah, I agree with you, because I got my wife. She's been in my band for nearly 30 years.
Yeah.
And I don't have to go looking for someone. She's here. It saves a lot of time and a lot of travel.
Right. You know, and if there's a family issue, it's in the band. So they can't go and leave because there's nowhere to go.
Yeah, but it's the best thing when you're related. Yeah, they can't say goodbye. I'm leaving the band.
It's hard to do that. It really is. I mean, what do you do on Christmas time? You're like, oh, hey, yeah, the band's still going and you're not in it. No, that's not it. That's not going to work.
Because that's a big problem. You know, they usually get rid of the drummer first. You know that. You're lucky you're in your own band.
Yeah.
Because they usually say goodbye to the drummer first in another band, don't they, when they make it?
Yeah, they do. I mean, I've been asked before. I've been asked by these sort of manager types to come out front and sing and then get some other drummer. But nobody, including me, is really interested in doing that, because then we'd have to find a whole other thing. Another drummer, who knows what they're going to be like. Then they'll probably be like in and out and in and out. You know, we don't want that. You know?
Yeah, but I love it. It's like the Romantics and it's like the Monkees. Mickey Dolan singing up front. I love it when the drummer sings. Dave Clark 5. It's great.
Yeah, I know. I know. You know, the trouble, the only trouble is I always get stuck in the back of the band, like in the on stage. I get stuck in the back and no venue understands. And they usually have the drums way in the back there. And I'm like, no. I'm the singer, so I got to be more out front. And they're like, well, tough. So we kind of make it work, though. We do. You know,
yeah,
that's
but that's great.
Thing.
Now tell me where you got the name Gripweeds. Where did that come from? The paddock in the garden or something? What is it?
Well, you know John Lennon, right? You heard of him?
Yeah.
You know the Beatles? You heard of them?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah, well, in 1966, he took a little break right before Sergeant Pepper. And he went off and he did a movie. And the movie was called How I Won the War.
Yeah, that's right.
And his character in the movie was Private Gripweed. And we thought, wow, that's a good name.
Thank you. I didn't know that. I thought it was like at the garden, you know, when you got weeds. Down here in Australia, we only know weeds in the garden. So I thought, what is it? Grip a weed, grab a weed, pull it out of the ground.
We've actually been trying to figure out for a while what the actual origin of that name could be. Because we picked it up from the movie, which was a book. And we don't know where they got it from. Maybe they got it from what you're talking about, the garden thing. It's possible, you know. But to me, it means it's kind of strong. And it's pretty much how we've sort of dealt with the world this whole time. We've hung on, you know, we're like a weed in the garden. It's tough to kill.
Exactly. But it's not like the Nerk twins or those other names that he had. Johnny, what was it, Silver? What was his other names he had?
Johnny Silver.
Paul had something Raimondo.
Paul Ramon, yeah. Well, you know, we had a few names before we had Gripweeds, but Gripweeds was the one, the Gripweeds, just, it stuck, you know, and that was the one, you know.
Because so if you were in the 60s, like the psychedelic era, and you're called Gripweeds, I don't think they'd be worrying about a character, do you know what I mean?
Well, you know, there's the other thing. If you know the Beatles, if you're really deep into the Beatles, you'll be like, oh, Gripweed, I know where they got that. But if you're not, maybe you're a stoner and you might go, hey, Gripweed, that's cool, man. We've had that. Even though we didn't think of it that way, it's not so bad. You know?
Yeah, but that's deep. You got to think. You know?
Yeah, exactly. You know, you got to, it makes you think. And that's what Gripweed does. Oh, Gripweed, what's that? You know? And so
not only are you a rock band, you're an intellectual band too.
We are. We think about what we do very carefully and seriously. Yeah, you should read our lyrics.
It's great, isn't it? Isn't it fantastic doing music in this time? Writing songs, relaxing, doing albums?
Yeah. You know, I'm just growing into it as a Gripweed does. You know, you grow into it. when I started out, I had one approach when we first started working. And now I'm more comfortable and more... getting more out of it, actually. So the music is getting deeper and richer from us. You know,
I believe you. That's what happens with time.
I think it does.
Look at the Rolling Stones. The Rolling Stones, they could change their name to the Rolling Bones.
Well, they're turning to stone. So I think stone is right.
Hey, listen, you know that song, Bob Dylan, Like a Rolling Stone. Do you know it?
Sure. Oh, we got to play? No.
Oh, you know, I had a comedian do that song, and I could not stop laughing. It's the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. That song, Like a Rolling Stone. It's amazing.
Yeah, Bob Dylan, he's great, and he's still rolling, too.
Who influences you from the 60s, apart from the Beatles and the Monkees?
Well, I mean, we kind of started out as a band really into a group called the Hollies. And we liked them because they were right around at the same time as the Beatles. They were making very Beatlesque music, but they did their own thing. And they had those great vocals, the three-part harmonies, and we really kind of wanted to explore those vocals, you know? And so they were one of the bands we really loved early on. The Zombies is another one, just a kind of a little more Baroque, I guess you could say. I mean, very complicated kind of music. So of the 60s, we really like that. I mean, the Kinks, we love them too. There's you know, there's so many bands. We get into a lot of the one-hit wonders too. You know, what's a band? The Merry-Go-Round, Emmett Rhodes. He just passed away. We love those guys. You know, they did.
I love Lola.
What?
I love that song, Lola.
Lola, sure.
Can you play a verse and a chorus of that? Don't do the whole song, just do a bit.
Let's see. The Mets are in a club down in Oso, where the drink champagne tastes good. Tastes just like Arizona. See you when they come. As I dare do.
You know, you can take off from that song straight into Donovan. You can see like the vibe goes from one artist to another. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, I think they're all connected. You know, Donovan was like living under a bridge when he was 16, you know, in London. So he was nothing. And they all, you know, I think the scene in England was very small in London in the 60s. They were all kind of, you know, they do Top of the Pops, they do the BBC, they all played these same clubs, you know? So it was a very tight scene, and they'd all see each other at night after the studio work. They'd go out to the Bag of Nails and hang out, you know? So I think they all kind of, you know, were in each other's pockets for a while, you know?
I got to say, Charles Rosenay's come on, and he said, "You're reeling and a rocking."
Well, I'm trying. I was just recording before this. I'm sorry I missed our original interview. I was recording and I didn't have my phone and I was so into it. And I'm in the studio here. Well, you can't really tell, but I'm here.
That's it. But don't worry. A song comes first. It's all right. When you get that song in your head, you got to lay it down. Don't worry. I understood 100%.
Yeah, you know, when the moment comes, you have to like capitalize on it. If you let it go, it's like a balloon. You know.
Yeah, but I got to tell you something. I wrote that song, "Hey Bananas, I Think You're Groovy," while I'm lying in the bath. The inspiration came to me. Proves two things: you can write a song anywhere and stay clean in the meantime.
Yeah, I like that. I'm gonna think. Yeah, I've written songs in the shower too, but no guitar to kind of work them out. You know. And electricity and shower water doesn't work.
But listen, I'm wondering how many famous songs got written on the crapper.
Yeah, I think about that too a lot, Plastic.
You know, you could be hit by a truck and the word comes, "Help."
Yeah, you know, I mean, you never know when the inspiration's going to strike. I'm a runner, okay? I'm a jogger. So I'm out jogging. And yeah, I'm getting my exercise, but I'm also working out songs. And I'm like, what am I going to do in the studio today? And how do I fix this song? And, you know, I'm writing songs. That song, Vibrations, I wrote that song when I was out running. And the whole thing came, and I had to put it all down as soon as I got back home. And I had to sing it the whole time I was out running, or I would have forgotten it. So that's how good songs, you know, come.
I liked it.
Thanks.
Anything you want to tell your fans? Anything you want to tell the grip waiters out there?
Well, you know, this is a real tough time. I don't know how you guys are feeling it down in Australia, but, you know, in the United States, we're still affected by this COVID-19. And it's stopping us from doing shows. And we're doing our best to continue working. And we're going to do some online shows. We did one in the end of May, and we're going to do another one coming up next month. So look for us. We're going to put it out on our site. We're going to do a live show for everyone. So that's really, you know, the best we could do right now. We miss everybody.
We're in curfew here. We can't leave our house from 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. So it's very important. People like yourself come out and entertain everybody. Like today was groove. I've become a fan of the Grip Weeds. Not that I wasn't before, but because I was interviewing you, look at this. I had to watch every interview. I had to watch every video you did. That's pretty good, isn't it?
Well, I mean, was it all right?
Yeah. I told you, I like that song, Vibrations.
They were all made with care. I can tell you that. You know, we worked them. We did our best. And if it wasn't our best, we didn't put it out, you know?
Anyway, I want to say from New Jersey, from Melbourne, New Jersey, take us out. It's Plastic EP and...
That would be me, Kurt Ryle from the Grip Weeds.
Stay there, Kurt. Thanks again.
Oh, thank you. This was a blast. See you from New Jersey.